thought that poetry only had one kind of meaning, to spill your guts, and you know, like, and I think there's time and space for it, but it's really important to offer hope as well, you know, and remember that the sun does shine again, and you know, so this is Little Old Bird. I heard from a little old bird that every poem doesn't deserve your bloodshed, that the ink that dances along journal entries does not have to be linked to poison, that presence on this stage need not be a confessional. This audience will not be my priest today, for I have learned the art of tithing, to release my treasures to an unchangeable God, to reach my arm toward buckets have yet been called, and to give my offerings to that which is worth my time. You see, there'll be no shame in this poem, no regrets that leave me empty and you thirsty. For who am I to tell you of such dry deserts without offering you a glass of water? I have discovered the creativity of my very temple. For example, my hands script stories of the unnoticeable characters in the ignored places with such unwavering faith. They learned how to interpret to the deaf and nearly blind men who could see more spark in me than my counterparts could. How my tongue developed tones when there are no languages to explain. How these eyes learn to discern evil, 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 and that which be not flesh for principalities. That these toes can reach countries full of black soil with blackened feet and oval bellies. There's a quote by Alice Walker that states, I think it angers God when you walk past the color purple in a field somewhere and don't notice it. So dear God, here is my acknowledgement that I am able to still dream beyond my bank account, to think beyond what the world tells me is impossible, to sing when there is no song but holy, holy, holy. I heard from a little old bird that every problem is solvable as long as you seek he who holds all the answers. Woo.